for you.
You probably realize this is a special program, so Sydney Kyte is purposely not playing any of the current dance tunes. Instead, he's revived several old numbers which are particularly identified with his band and has also chosen several new ones which have not been broadcast in this country before. Well, then back we go to 1925, when Sydney Kyte was the deputy leader of the original Savoy All Fierce. And the hit of the day, now to be sung to you by Helen Mackay, was that great old tune, Valencia.
Valencia, land of oranges and wheat, and can't you call me from afar? Valencia, where a love of fruit is bent and land upon a light star. Valencia, let me hold a rose between my lips for Rome and Jerusalem. Beneath the moon must throw my heart away. In my dreams I hear you singing like you used to do, and the dance keeps sweetness bringing memories of you. Oh, Colum, oh, Colum, where are you? The love I am needing, did governor wait in the moonlight just to hear you sing. Valencia, where the passion in the song, the love of things beneath the moon.
When the Savoy Orpheans recorded that number, Valencia, this is rather interesting. There was such a public demand for it that the master record wore out, and the band had to go to the studios to re-record it, which is almost an unheard-of thing nowadays. Well, now, come on, we'll skip a few years and come to Body and Soul, one of the most haunting dance melodies ever been written, and a big favorite among the members of Ciro's Club, where Sydney Kyte was appointed musical director in 1930. The singer tonight is Jack Plant.
Conceive it that you turn away romance. Are you pretending? Don't say it's the ending. I wish I could have one more chance to prove my life a hell you're making. You know I'm yours for just the taking. I gladly surrender. myself to you, body and soul.
Get along, get along, get along, get along, get along, get along, get along.
I'm heading for the land round us, to the faraway ranch of the boss in the sky, where the strays are counted and branded. There go I'm heading for the last round of. Get along, little doggy, get along.
Now back we go again to English humor. Norman Cole, who was deputy leader of Sydney Kyte's Piccadilly Hotel Orchestra, is going to transport you to the Tower of London, where the ghost of Anne Boleyn walks with her head tucked underneath her arm.
Tower of London, large as life, the ghost of Anne Boleyn there walks, they do declare. For Anne Boleyn was once King Henry's wife, until he made the headsman bob her hair. And yes, he did a wrong long years ago, and she comes up at night to tell him so, with her head stoop. Underneath her arm she walks the tower, with her head stuck underneath her arm at the midnight hour. She comes to haunt King Henry, she means giving him what for. Gadzooks, she's going to tell him off for having spilt her gore. And just in case the headsman wants to give her an encore, she has her head tucked underneath her arm. With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks the tower. With her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. Along the drafty corridors for miles and miles she goes. She often catches cold, poor thing, it's colder when it blows. And it's awfully awkward for the Queen to have to blow her nose, with her head tucked underneath her arm. Carries in, and when they've had a few, they shout, "Is Arsenal going to win?" They think it's Teddy Drake instead of poor old Anne Boleyn, with her head tucked underneath her arm.
Well, 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 so much for the past. Now for a glimpse into the future. The band is going to give the first broadcast performance of a new composition. This is a study in the ultra-modern entitled Subway. It's a descriptive piece depicting the rattle and the roar of New York's Underground Railway. Then after this, we're going to have a new waltz tune The Girl in the Alice Blue Garb. That'll be sung to you by Jack Clark.
Thank you.
it's your turn to tell them something about the next piece.
Well, as a contrast to the previous tunes the band has played, we now present what I can best describe as a symphonic swing arrangement of Liszt's Immortal Liebestraum. This is not a light-hearted attempt at jazzing the classics, but a transcription of the work for the modern dance orchestra in which the melody is sustained against a rhythmic background.
Here's another brand new fox trot. This time, a very colorful tune broadcast for the first time in this country called Hawaiian Hospitality. Well, this number, incidentally, is written by the authors of Sweet Villani. Well, tonight, Helen Mackay is the singer, and the electric guitar is played by Ray Prince.
Whispers come into my arms.
just the old Hawaiian hospitality. And though my heart may fall too low when I sail away, my heart will throb to the thought of coming.
Comes a rather intriguing instrumental novelty called The Wedding of Pocahontas. Sydney Kyte tells me this is the first time you have heard it over the air. And then after this, the band's going to revive another of those popular comedy songs which Sydney Kyte introduced to British listeners all over Italy, sung this evening by Helen Mackay and Jack Plant.
La 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 la
la la la la la la.
They sing when they work.
They sing when they play. When they feel sad and when they feel gay.
All over Italy, they sing so prettily. La 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 la.
La 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 la.
I'm afraid it's the end of the program. The signature is
Sydney Kyte and his band,
with Jack Plant, Helen Mackay, and as guest artist Norman Coe. The signature tune is